And how many of you are familiar with The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe? So I was going to tell the parents, if you hadn't seen this and got this movie, you go home and tell your parents to get this movie. Yes, because this great theme that we're celebrating today, the Lion, Mighty Aslan. Here they come. Whoa! They went and gathered you up out there. Tell me your names again.
Enrico.
You have a name?
Soulmate.
Anna. So, are you familiar with The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe? Have you seen the movie? Then I'm telling you, you go tell your parents, they have to go rent this movie and have you watch it. Because this is one of the great stories that illustrates what we've been celebrating on today, the Lion and the Witch and the Wardrobe. There's a kid in this story named Edmund. He does some pretty bad things, and he gets in trouble, and he's going to be punished. Lion shows up, and the lion takes his punishment. I always thought this was a great part of the story, because when my parents punished me, I always thought, if only that lion would show up. But the lion came and took Edmund's punishment out of love and compassion. And in that movie, there's this great scene where they bind the lion, put him on an altar, sacrifice, and they shave off his mane. This powerful image. C.S. Lewis was telling the gospel through stories. It's not just a story, it's the truth about God's love for us and the way Jesus Christ reaches out and touches us. So, I've only seen the film about 7 or 8 times. I've read the book probably 7 or 8 times. It's a great story. So, if you haven't seen it lately, I encourage you, and I encourage you. This is a great story, and it's all about the lion of the tribe of Judah who is willing to be killed and suffer in order to save us. And that's all I want to say to you today. And I thank you for being brilliant here.